Last night I heard another couple of chapters from the book called Lords and Ladies. Here's what happened. Magret had found out that Granny Weatherwax and Agnes Knit were trying to outstare the sun. She had gone down to find it out, and Nanny had confirmed it with her. The two witches were there. Granny was not doing that well. Nanny knew that she was going to have to stop soon, but she was not going to commit defeat from it because she did not want to be kicked out of where she knew and where she was the best witch for them at that time period. No one else would have been a better witch. Not even Agnes Snit would be a better witch in that spot called the Roundland. Granny knew that she had to do it her way and not any other way. Granny knew that it was going to happen the way she needs it to happen. Granny always knows this. Granny is not someone who ever takes the word no as an answer. She always just lets it happen the way she needs it to happen. And if that means she has to find a way to cheat, to trick someone, she'll find a way to trick someone. She is not taking no, I'm not doing it as an answer. She will do it her way or the highway. It was very, very good to hear. Honestly, I don't know what's going to happen next. I can't really remember what's going to happen next. I haven't read this book for a while. It was really, really good to hear. Nanny had to get the sun to move into front of it just to stop them from doing the staring contest so no one would win, because Granny would not give up. Oh, my word, that woman does not give up. She would just keep staring and staring and staring and staring and staring and possibly hurt her eyes. I have a video of someone with wrecked eyes and all that, and I have pictures of everything about wrecked eyes and a brain and everything. I honestly think it's really important to the blog post at the moment. Okay, so there really isn't much else to say, so that is all for now.